Welcome to the tutorial series on research materials. In this tutorial, we learn how to read and understand a research paper. This provides a step-by-step guide for the beginners who just want to start their research. We start with the first step, which is to begin by reading the introduction, not the abstract. You need to directly jump on the introduction section without reading the abstract. Most of the researchers who don't know how to read a scientific paper start reading the abstract first. Even I also used to read the abstract first when I don't know these tips about the understanding a paper. So the abstract is that dense paragraph at the very beginning of a paper that is often the only part of a paper that many non-scientists and untrained persons read when they are trying to build a scientific argument or concept. So I suggest to read the abstract at last because it contains a succinct summary of the entire paper, including material and methods and results and discussions and conclusion. So when you go through all the sections of the paper, then it will easy to read the abstract of the paper. So in introduction section, you need to identify the big question. This means you need to identify what problem is this entire field trying to solve, not just the specific paper. Means you need to search the problem in which the entire study or the subject of the paper is covering or studying. For example, if you are reading a paper related to COVID-19 determinants or risk factors, then you are basic problem is to find the determinant or to see the association of the risk factors and the COVID-19 outcome. So you first need to identify what is the big question of the field, not the specific paper. This helps to focus on why this research is conducted. When you know what the problem the whole field is solving, then you will come to the main idea or main focus of the paper. So look closely for evidence of agenda-motivated research. Agenda-motivated research means your research or the paper is motivated toward an agenda. So this provide a more interesting depth about the paper. Third step is to summarize the background in 5 sentences or less. When you read or skim through the introduction section, then you will be able to read 5 sentences or less than 5 sentences about the introduction. These sentences may answer the following questions: what has been done before in this field to answer the big question? As I we already discussed what is a big question. So you need to write down the work which has been done before in this field to answer the questions. For example, you need to list all the works related to COVID-19 determinants or to see the association between the COVID-19 outcome and its risk factors. The second thing is what are the limitation of that work, what was the limitation, what were the limitation of the works already conducted in literature, and what according to the author need to be done. This is basically the gap, what gap of the study, on which on the basis of that gap the author written the current paper. You should be able to succinctly explain why this research has been done in order to understand the paper. That is the most important thing you need to understand. When you find the gap, when you clear what work has been done and what were the limitations of those works, and what the author going to do next, these all things lead to succinctly explain, lead to become you able to succinctly explain why the research has been done in order to understand the whole paper. The next thing is identify the specific questions. When you have clear idea what the paper is intended to do, or what question the paper is going to answer, then you need to identify the specific questions, which are the research questions present in the paper. What exactly are the authors trying to answer with their research? This is the basically research statement, which you will find at the end of the introduction of every scientific paper. There may be multiple questions or just one, so write down them. If it's the kind of research that test one or more null hypotheses, then identify the null hypothesis on the basis of their null hypothesis. You will be able to understand the other or the material and method section and result section of the paper. The fifth step is to identify the approach, which is the whole method of the paper or method used in the paper. What the authors going to do to answer the questions you identified in previous step. And the sixth step is read the method section thoroughly. You need to draw a diagram for each experiment. If there were more than one experiment, then you need to draw a separate diagram for each experiment showing exactly what the authors did. You need to or draw a complete roadmap through which the author came to compute his result, or he reached to his result, and include as much detail as you need to fully understand the work. In this same step, write one or more paragraph to summarize the result. This is the seventh step, where you need to read the result section. Write one or more paragraph to summarize the result for each experiment. For each experiment, you need to summarize the result, and from each figures and each table. At this stage, you need to note that don't yet try to decide what the result means. Just write down what they are. You need to just put down or write down the results of the paper, not try to interpret the results at this stage. You will often find that results are summarized in the figures and tables, so be carefully do attention to the figures and tables in the paper, where you can easily find the results and summarize them. You may also need to go to supplementary online information or materials to find some of the results. Some paper mention the supplementary material. I'll refer the readers to go to the supplementary material of the paper. So don't forget to see or visit the supplementary online information related to the paper. Also pay attention to the word like significant and insignificant, non-significant. These are the precise statistical, these has the precise statistical meaning. So don't forget to pay attention these words. In some sentence you found significant, that means there is a significant relationship between two factors, or there is a significant effect of some factor on the outcome. So you will need to pay special attention on these words, and also pay on graphs. Do the graphs have error bars on them? For certain types of studies, a lack of confidence interval is a major red flag. Means if there were no confidence interval in certain type of studies, then there is something wrong in the paper. You need also to check what was the sample size in the study. For some research purpose, a smaller sample size like 10 is sufficient, but for most of the studies, larger sample size is preferred. And the eighth step is to determine whether the results answer the specific questions. When you write down and summarize the result, then you can compare the results to the questions you identified at your identification stage, and see whether you are whether the results answer the specifications, what do you think they mean, and don't move until you have thought about this. Until you have no decision about the results, you need to stuck on the result and don't move ahead. It's okay to change your mind in light of the author's interpretation. You can make your own interpretation. I think this is a good habit, to start forming your own interpretation before you read those of the others. Read the conclusion, discussion, and interpretation section. In this section, you need to while reading this section, you need to ask following question to yourself: what do the authors think the result mean? This is the author's interpretation of the result. Do you agree with them? Do you agree with the interpretation made by the authors? Can you come up with any alternative way of interpreting them? And do the author identify any weakness in their own study? Do you see any that the author missed? If you found any limitation of the author's study, then you need to note them. Don't assume they are infallible. What do they propose to do as a next step? Do you agree with that? These all things you can find in discussion and interpretation stage and conclusion stage. And go back to the beginning and read the abstract at this stage. Does it match what the author said in the paper? Now you can compare the author's statement in the abstract to the work he or they done in the whole paper. Does it fit with your interpretation of the paper? And you need to also check whether your interpretation of the paper fits with the abstract of the paper. And at 11th stage, find out what other researchers say about the paper. These are the comments by the acknowledged or self-proclaimed expert in the particular field. Do they have criticism of the study that you have not thought of? or do they generally support the interpretation or the conclusion made by the author? Don't neglect to do this. Here is a place where I do recommend you to use Google Scholar or ResearchGate, but do it last so you are better prepared to think critically about what other people say. So guys, these are the important steps while reading a research paper. If you think this video is worthy to watch, then you don't forget to share with others and subscribe the channel. I will make more videos related to research, writing and reading of the papers. So keep notified with the studio or the channel. Thank you.